I'm Bill Dietrich. I'm a professor in the Department of Earth and Planetary Science here at UC Berkeley. And I'm a geomorphologist, so that means I'm interested in the form and the evolution of landscapes. Our group is focused on watersheds. A watershed is the area that drains to a common point. The Eel River drains about 9,500 square kilometers, and it has only one dam on it. It's one of the least disturbed watersheds in all of Northern California. And it has a significant salmon run in it. Every 2 weeks, our group goes up to the Eel River watershed to make measurements to figure out how the watershed works.
This area that we're driving through right now is in the Northern California coast ranges. Yeah, so our plan for the day is to collect water samples from a lot of different wells and from the streams at this site.
My name is Jesse Hamm, and I'm a PhD student at the University of California, Berkeley, and I work in Bill Dietrich's lab. So we have two field sites here in the Eel River watershed. This one, which is a grassland, and our second site, which is an evergreen forest. At both sites, we're collecting lots of data to understand how much water is in the critical zone. The critical zone is this layer above fresh rock where all of the water is stored. When rain comes, it percolates down, and then that groundwater is slowly flowing downhill all the time. And as it flows downhill, it meets the streams, and that's where the water in the stream is coming from. It's kind of like a big sponge in the subsurface. And one of the most important things to know is how thick is that sponge? And once we know that, we can then ask how much water is in that sponge. When we want to know how much water is in the critical zone, we drill holes into the ground and then we just look to see where the water rises to in the wells.
So this is one of our wells, and right now we are going to figure out how deep it is to the water table. And we're going to use this device, which goes down and then it beeps once it hits the groundwater.
We have a variety of instruments that we can drop down the wells. Most of them are measuring how much water is in the subsurface, and they're also telling us where the water table is.
Yeah, so 6.85.
My name is Sammy Cargill, and I'm a field technician at the Eel River Critical Zone Observatory. So one of the things that I typically do is collect water samples. We basically collect a large bottle of water from either a well or a stream, wherever we're collecting it from. And then we want to subsample it, so we want to put it into smaller bottles that we use to run different tests on. When we collect data in the field, we write everything down in our field books. We want to make sure that we collect good quality data so that nothing is compromised. The numbers that we get actually reflect what's going on.
Ready to load up?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Stay high. All
right.
Away we go. Today we're at our Rivendell field site in the Eel River watershed, and we will be collecting similar data to yesterday. We probably want to go down to about 20.5 meters. I like my job as a field technician because I get to go outside all the time. I get to see new things every time I go to work. I get to experience all the different types of weather that occur, see the seasons pass.
By studying the critical zone, we understand how much water this watershed can store. The data that we've collected at this site has shown that the critical zone is much thicker here, and that means that it can store a lot more of the winter rains. The ecosystem here has a lot higher productivity. There's bigger trees and bigger forests, And it also means that the water in the critical zone can feed the streams here year-round. And that year-round flow in the streams is really important for sustaining native fish species that live in the creeks here.
All the water flowing in streams in California during the summer comes from hill slopes and comes specifically from the critical zone. So this region underneath hill slopes that extends down to fresh bedrock is like a sponge that stores water in the winter and slowly releases it in the summer. And that slow release is what controls flow in California streams. It's why there are salmon in California. We're thinking of the watershed by looking at a hill slope as a building block of a watershed. And so if you can understand how the hydrology works of a hill slope, one hill slope, really well, then you can say, well, I just multiply that times all the hill slopes in a watershed and I can tell how the watershed works. The value of that, or the approach of that, is if we understand how things really work, we think we can get a better prediction or explanation of how watersheds will store and release water and how they respond to climate change and land use.